Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CT Films. Recently, I was going to try out the Xbox Cloud Gaming app on my MetaQuest, but for some reason, I can't download it. If anyone knows how to download it and get it installed, please let me know. Thanks. Anyways, then it is using an Xbox Series S controller or any Xbox controller in general, which I'll mention in a minute. Then it is using USB Type-C. Now, I do have a particular cable by you and Green, hashtag not sponsored, but this is a USB Type-C to USB Type-C. Now, in theory, then it is using an angle. I do recommend you using an angle thing. And in theory, you should be able to hook this up using a wired connection, so to say, because I tried to look up videos about it on YouTube, but I couldn't find any, and that is using a wired connection on an Xbox controller. So as you can see, despite hooking it up with my whatever hands I'm using, because I could do more hands actually, than is hand tracking. But yeah, you can actually hook this up using an Xbox controller, using a wired connection, using USB Type-C to USB Type-C, and it just works, so to say, once you plug it in. We'll get to other controllers in a bit, but once you hook it up, like this scenario, then it's using an L-shape, which I do recommend using an L-shape thing, adapter, and then you just look like this, as a dingus. Once you're hooked up the wired connection to your MetaQuest, I do recommend you go into your device settings, and go to gamepad, and enable this feature. Now this will let you, in theory, not let you use the hands. Basically you can just use this without the hands, because why would you use your hands for to control stuff? And you can actually use the controller and head tracking to be able to navigate through the thing, as you can see right here. I'm just navigating, using the controller and buttons, because why would you need your hands? You play this with your hands, there's a baby's toy. So you can actually navigate using the controller, and as you can see, I'm using my head to navigate, and also using the thumbsticks to scroll up and down, etc. It's just very, very convenient than just using your hands. And if you lose your controllers, your left and right controllers, then this is a good method to be able to play this. Why would you use your hands? If you just type your thing in. And as you can see, I'm trying to install the Bluein Xbox Bluein app, but it won't let me. Anyway, if anyone knows, just let me know. But yeah, that's that in a nutshell. Now, I bet you're saying to yourself, but Stephen, I only have this Xbox controller that doesn't have Bluetooth enabled. Well, you can actually use this, literally. But the problem is you have to use a USB type micro, then A to, you know. And yeah, it's a bit of an awkward scenario. But you have to use this adapter, which is a USB type C to A, and then you plug it in and it does work also, sadly to say. Even though it does look ridiculous once you plug it in with the adapter and then you plug that in with the L-shape thing, which again, I do recommend the L-shape adapter, which does work by all means. But once you plug it in by micro USB that doesn't have a Bluetooth connection, this is an old Xbox One controller by all means since launch. And yeah, you just plug it in by USB Type-C that way, using an L-shaped thing. And then once you plug it all in, it does actually work, honestly. I do recommend this if you want to go through this method, but you do get a bit of a dongle thing like that, look like a more dingus like that with a dongle. Now, there are not many controller-enabled apps. Well, they might work on some of them, but it might be varied. I even tried the Steam Link, but it asked me to use the other controllers. But anyway, so I downloaded Tetris and Kinect Effect, whatever it's called, and that uses the controllers. So I enabled them by just playing it, and it just works deliberately, natively, and then I can just play Tetris using the D-pad, as you can see by more awkwardness on there and playing Tetris. But yeah, it just worked by the controller you'd have to use. We can use your normal controllers, but if you do lose them, then there's a method of just using an Xbox controller wired or wireless. But I'm just showing you this video that it does work wired. Then it's using one of the methods using the controller also. So that's my video for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. It was just like a thing that I just discovered. I couldn't find any YouTube videos about it being wired, then it's wireless. Then it is playing on that Bluein Xbox app that I want to play on that Xbox app eventually at some point. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.